Taste of PNG is brought to you by Origin Energy.
Welcome back to Tokyo, in Japan. I have my beautiful kanshuga. We're going to use it. We're going to make some lovely dessert with that. Who will have thought it? Tokyo, in Papua New Guinea, not in Japan. It is a small village in Golala, and I'm lucky enough to go there with airborne logistics without crashing and meet those lovely people before I go back to my lovely kitchen. Wow. Hey, Peter.
Yes. Morning.
Morning, brother. You all right?
You're right.
You working with him?
Me like making flower blommy, mixing flower blommy now.
Okay.
From Ibn Kaikai.
Okay. What name Kaikai kai you like him making?
Scone.
Scone, eh? Flower you kiss him where?
Flower mix him, it's like chopper yak simikamna, me by salem.
Before no got flower, eh?
Before, yes, lick, me plus have sim lick, but now.
Plenty stuff now.
Yes. Flower come inside law, this like place, law, March 14th. 2016.
And Tassola. Time you got flower, you cook the garden food, right? Tassola.
Yes,
Time you cook him cocoa, you dry him lick, and you smash him, you can make scone with it.
Big
plate no saber, Tassola. Big plate saber no mimi, big plate chef, so talk saber Tassola. You make him cake Tassola or you make him scone?
Scone Tassola.
Scone Tassola. Okay, you put him one emerald scone for you.
Me put him water, mix him, not straight. Low dish, suppose me mix good.
No.
Put in frying pan, low fire.
I'm working bread.
Fire, put him grease inside, or sauce pan. Frying pan.
Do you plan make him sweet or not? God?
No, God.
You plan got banana, bro, more banana, you got sobla something, bro, or not? God?
Me plan got plenty banana.
Okay. Time you make him sweet banana cake, or peanuts cake, or get something, make your plug, or donuts. You sabe make him donuts or not? God?
No God.
And same principle. Flour, water. You got can sugar stab lo hap, look at them blow you?
Yes.
Push him down, sugar he come, mix him lo hap, sweet he come. You sabe? But by the time he come back, me go cook him some blah donuts for you blah. So you look good, look. Sabe blow me, yeah. Don't make him good blah. Maskilo, bread tassel. Bread him alright. But lick sweet blow piggy, yeah. You sabe? You think him one?
M by good blah.
M a good blah, eh?
No, sense him lick. Awesome.
And that's all.
Taste
New pla save. Yes. He come up. Yes. Lick something, he come blow up. Lick something, he come blow up. And make him one simple, but good kai. You save, yeah.
Yes.
Flour is tap everywhere. Flour is tap of fish. Flour is tap of sausage. Licking both flour, he come blow shop. Look, you must be all get a village blow me pla. And kai flour. Did I write on a god?
You talk true.
And that's all, yeah. And you like him bread. La country blow me is the same. We love bread. So, Peter, where do you like flower?
You got plenty area. Why me like him plenty flower? Or me like him flower? Or no change him diet, blow cow he come, blow flower. Or on man like him money, lawyer. Or by buy him, blow me. And or by, or maybe by go fry him, salem, tick, or by kai. 2+ something. No salem like him money back, or by kai, what I family blow.
Good plan, yes. Good plan. So, let me say, who's the best cook?
Me, I cannot identify anybody here because
no.
Olgata,
or
buy lo me, or yet or go lo making the way blow.
Okay, so time is saying flower go out and make him scone, huh?
Yes.
Yeah, that's typical Papua New Guinea.
Yes.
Everybody likes scone up here, everybody. You go anywhere in the market, you go anywhere, the people up here and eat a lot of bread because you're a bread lover.
Yes.
So time you must think some platan. You're making some press sweet too. Bread, I'm all right. Sometimes you can't have morning, no bread, or can't have no breakfast. I'm okay. You must kiss him, lick sugar. Papa sugar is tablab. Mix him low flour and making some bread with it. And kiss him sweet, lick lick. And that's all. There we are. As you see, flour is a big thing in Papua New Guinea. We make cake, we make bread, we make flour balls, we use it for cooking, we make gravy. Anything else we use it for? Flour?
I think emtasol.
Emtasol,
because
no.
I use him low. Simdiglik toya back.
I'm not. So are you selling all the flour? You kiss him no shopper? No company come no kissing vegetable blue you pla.
Yes.
And you sell him all community in by
yes.
flour.
We sell him low now by.
Good plan, man.
Yes.
Peter, use the flour only for cooking, that's all,
huh? Emtasol.
No, something else no got.
No got.
And flour blow me from looking like. You see flour and butter.
Oh,
good plan, huh? Good plan, man. All Peter, good plan, man. My mama so come to Village Blue, a beautiful place.
Thank you.
Good plan, man. Good plan, man, to you. God bless you.
God bless.
God bless the community. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Mitam now, mitam logona.
Okay.
Thank you,
thank
too.
You.
I'm not stick blooming, I'm canchiga. Okay. Well, it's time to go now. It's time to make some pâtisserie, some pastry. We'll see you later. Okay, everybody. Au revoir. Bye-bye. Au revoir. Merci. Stay with us. Up next, a lovely apple pie. Welcome back to the show, Taste of PNG. Taste of PNG is not only about cooking, it's about people too, obviously. We all love apple. We got plenty of apple in Gordon, in my garden. So I went to pick up some apple from the tree this morning. And we're going to make a beautiful, lovely apple pie. Apple pie for the pastry. 500 grams of flour, 100 grams of sugar, 150 grams of butter, 100 ml of coconut milk. For the filling, you will need 6 to 7 apples, 400 ml of fresh cream, 2 eggs, and 100 grams of sugar. So to make an apple pie, first of all, you have to make a pastry. So we're going to make a pastry together. I'll put the flour in a mixer. It's about 300 grams of flour, self-raising, no, plain flour. So I got flour, I got sugar, about 200 grams. It's big, like a shortbread. So I got about 200 grams of sugar. I got a bit of salt. Up here, 1 teaspoon, plenty. And I got my butter, about 150 grams of butter that I put in there. There we are. I will take my hand. That's it. So we're going to mix that lovely things together with that lovely mix of mine. So we have 200 grams of milk up here. All right, there we are. Transfer the salt in the mix. And I try to get a bit of blend them up together to when she got to a, like a paste. I will show you after when I'm finished with it. And that's easy. There we done. Obviously, and it's nice. I will finish it by hand up here, so I will show you how. So we're going to give it a bit of twist by hand to make sure she's nice and mixed properly. And that's what we have. I will get some flour because it's a bit sticky. That means it's sticky, so I have flour up here. So we spread it up a little bit. So it's nice. And I roll them up on the shape. It's on the shape. Good. Perfect. So when we're done the pastry have to rest a little bit for a while. Door is down. It's nice and flexible. What I have to do now, I have to put the door into the tray, the baking tray. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to pick up my tray now. What's wrong with it? It doesn't work anymore. Ah, sorry. Ah, honestly, there we are. Oh. That is a baking tray, the same one, beautiful one. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to roll the things by hand, like that. The plastic is good, it's flexible, lovely. Bit of flour on the hand. I'm doing that in case if you don't have any roller, rolling pin in the house. So that's the tray up here. What I'm going to do, I'm going to roll my pastry like that. Slowly, We'll bring to the tree up here, and we'll dispose it on top of the tree, like that. That's what we do. So don't be bound. So we're going to adjust it, bring it up here, bring it up down there. So it's all even all over the place. Thank you. That's it. Put him on there. Lovely. I'm going to cut it. So with my knife, I'm going to cut the outside. There we are. That's what we are. That's what we're doing. On the side, lovely everywhere. A bit of flour. It's sticky a bit. The paste is fresh when it comes up from the oven. Obviously, perfect. Done. Finish. Next steps. We're going to cut the apple to make the apple pie. There we are. We've got beautiful apple. I peel the apple, obviously. So I'm going to get that part out down there. Twist with the knife. Bang. Put him in there. I'm going to cut him half. And I'm going to cut him half again. Okay. Remove the middle. The middle is not good. Okay. So how are we cutting the apple? I want the shape in there, so we go 1, 2. She's lucky. I'll go like that, better. 1, 2, 3. And I said 1 and 2. All the apples have to be skinned. The skin is not very nice. And it's not something you want to eat with the apples. And it's not going to look good on your apple pie. So now we're going to do the next steps. We're going to put the apple in the apple pie. We go around, around and around. It will take about 6-7 apples to do an apple pie. Yeah, the apples are cheap, they're not as expensive, so it's all right. You go all the way on top. So you want to a good design when you go up. It's not something you just throw in there, bang, bang, bang. Now we go to stage number 2. Now we're going to do the sauce. So the sauce, it's easy. I got about 400 ml of fresh cream. I have about 100 grams of sugar that we pour in there, gently, okay? I'll finish with that. And I will have 2 eggs, again, I mix it on that one. 1, another eggs, and it's 2. And we're going to whisk it together, slowly. That's going to be your filling. Well, we have to have the eggs in there, because if there was no eggs, the cream will not thick. So there will be the thick, like everything to do with cream and eggs, it thick together. So I give them when they cook with the apple, it stuck together, this is lovely. It's beautiful. Look at it, how creamy is it. Okay, now, so we got the cream, we got the eggs, we got the sugar, blended together, and that will go on top. So now, there we are. I will take the apple pie to the oven. Come here. They will put it in the oven, lovely. Nice, and we go down there. Perfect. The apple pie will cook for about 25 minutes, 190 degrees. So that's good. I could go for a break now. I will come back in 20 minutes and see if it's cooked or not. A plus tard. There we're back. We've got 25 minutes, 30 minutes. We're going to take the apple pie out. Oh, lovely. Lovely. Oh, lovely. Look at that. This is perfect. So, she's a bit hot. And now, an apple pie. Good for afternoon tea, coffee, anything with your friend. If you got no friend, eat it all by yourself. That's what I do with me. Excellent. So now, we're going to cut one piece. We should wait a little bit, but everybody's hungry, so I'm going to cut one little piece, and I'll show you how it looks like. And I'm going to cut one piece down there. Lovely. So that's mine, up here. It's going to be a bit, that's the one. That's your apple pie maison. It is full of apple, it is lovely. Perfect. Hoping you learned a whole lot today, and it's simple things, and simple things we're going to work it up together. We finished with the apple pie, lovely. Stay with me. Next, we're going to do some more amazing pastry cooking. Love it. See you shortly. Don't go away. Stay with us. Don't go anywhere. Up next, we're making donuts. Welcome back to Taste of PNG. It's a dessert and pastry cooking week, so we have something special for you today. Something all Papua New Guinean people does. And I see them at the market or at the school. It's the donuts. Donuts, you will need 400 grams of flour, 150 grams of sugar, 2 tablespoons of yeast, 1 teaspoon of salt, 200 grams of coconut flour, 200 grams of butter, 200 ml of coconut milk, all mixed together. So to start with, it's easy. We're going to pour the flour into the mixer. There we are, don't need that one. We're going to pour the butter. It doesn't want to go, the butter goes. We're going to pour the sugar. The sugar's gone. We're going to pour the salt, the yeast, the eggs. You need eggs on the donuts. Eggs give them more flavor and give a bit of a lift. Because most of fine up the donuts we're doing up here, they're too strong. There we are. We're going to start the mixer, and we're going to start to mix what we have in there. And I'm going to pour my milk now in there. To when you obtain a nice and firm mix, I will show you how. What I have up here is not a flour, it's a coconut flour. So I will put that coconut flour into the mix, about 200 grams. Just touch it, see how firm is it. It's getting there, slowly. A little remaining of the 100 grams of flour. There we are, all done. Mix it for about 7 minutes or by hand to when you got a moist and nice mix. And I will show you next when I take it out. Then we're going to check the mix now, see if everything's all right or not. Perfect. You want something a bit sticky. You don't want something too dry because if it's too dry, it's never going to rise down there. So I'm going to take off the hook. And I will show you what I mean about it. This is the mix we should have. So I'm going to get some of that to show you. Actually, when you do donuts mix, it should stay overnight in the fridge, overnight, all the time. See the door? It's nice and flexible, lovely, good flavor, perfect. So what we're going to do, we're going to let the dough rest for about 1 hour or 2 hours, okay? And after that, we might be able to cook it. Just move the fix up here, move it down there, and it's the dough for the donuts. Nice and small. The donuts I'm doing is not the donuts you're doing in Papua New Guinea. It's a different donut. It's more like a shortbread donut, and I will show you how. I will show you how. So down. There we are. We're going to let him rest for a while. Give it about 2 hours. And when it's going to be rest for 2 hours, we go to the next steps and we're going to shape them. I'm going to have a break. We'll see you when I come back for the break and we're going to roll the donuts together. For time being, I'm going to leave them on the table, roll them up, and make sure they stay here. That's it. Put him in a place, get a cloth, cover it with a cloth, let them sleep for 2 hours. In the meantime, when they sleep, you could have a cup of coffee or something like I'm going to do now. I will see you shortly. Don't go anywhere. I'll be back shortly. We are back from the break. The donuts door looks perfect. She rests a little bit. As I said, it's a different type of donuts than the one you've done previously. And I will show you the one we do where I come from. That's the one. So we're going to cut him in half. And we're going to mold them. I'm going to mold them by hand. So we have a piece up here. I get them pieced down there with a bit of flour and I will flat them down. You don't want to flatten them too much. You want to give a bit of space on it so they're long enough and they're perfect enough to do what I want to do. We cut them like that. One. I go here. It's up to you. The shape you want to give is the shape you want to give. We don't want to give that shape. We give another shape. Okay. I do a middle, a hole on the middle. Up here. And there. So when I take my donuts, we got the hole on the middle up here. We go from there, twist it up from there, and we go from the inside up here, twist it up on the inside, so you got all that curly, curly things coming up. This is lovely. Another one, again. You see the thickness? There's a thickness you want for the donuts, because you want a bit of meat on it, huh? So again, up here, and again, down there. Now, we're going to cook them. So I put some oil up here, not too hot, because we don't want to burn the dough. So I'm going to get the first donut in. There we are. They go inside. Obviously, I got another one up here. So we got two donuts up here. So now we're going to turn them around because obviously that size is cooked already. Lovely, beautiful. Oh, Francois, you're good, mate. You're so good. Give it another 2 minutes, we'll take them out. So now I know you people have been doing the donuts, you put the yeast on it, you're waiting for the donuts to come up, and the donuts come up, everything come up, the house come up, and you cook them. And you go to school and sell them for $50. I will come up to make a donut so it will look bigger and cheaper than what you make in the house. Believe me. So now, we're going to take the first donut out. Here are the first donuts coming up. And you see, lovely, perfect. We got the other one out. Slowly. They look bigger, but they're not that big, but they're very, very, very nice. They're very good. They're excellent donuts. We do them in France for the Carnival Day. Carnival, am I right? Carnival, huh? Is this the one? So we cook two at a time. It's lovely. Look at that. Excellent. That's it. We turn them up and turn them up on the other way. Lovely. Let them cook a little bit. That's it. So they cooked. Perfect. Golden brown. Perfect. Excellent. Just take it off the excess of oil on it because it's not good for you. We got another plate. And we got the big one. That's mine. The big papa one. That's the one. Bang. You're going to play it too. On that side. We got two more to go, the last one, and it's one, and it's two. We need it done. This one are cooking. I'm going to dress couples of them with chocolate to show you how they look like it. Okay? So we're going to get the big boy there, and that one down there. Oh, we got three of them. One, two, three, one, two, three. Yes, what we're going to do. And that one up here. There we have our plain donuts, nice and soft, beautiful, lovely, fresh. Straight from the fry pan, straight from the pot, and I'm going to splash them up with chocolate. Okay, so here we are, the same principle that we've done before. We're going to splash them all up. Lovely, gorgeous. No. So ready to be eaten, ready to be eaten. There we are. Lovely, delicious. And you have your plain one, better one. There we are. Take the stove out, get the other donuts out. Lovely, perfect, very good. What you could do in house, just an idea. Get the dough, get the savoy, put the savoy in the middle on the outside and you have a sausage flour. It'll be the same, it'll be beautiful. Just something to think about it. There we are. Beautiful donuts. The speciality up here. The choco donuts, and I'm going to put on top one of my special preferred dish, lovely dish, a caramel. So I'm going to put some caramel on it to make it nice and sticky, lovely. Look at that, yummy, yummy, yummy. Oh, lovely, 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 lovely. And now, and of course, I'm going to sprinkle it with a special sprinkly. You buy the sprinkly in the shop anywhere in Papua New Guinea. They like the sprinkly. There we are. Lovely, look at that. Lovely. That looks very, very nice. There we are, the final product. Thank you to be with us. It was lovely to cook together again and have this lovely donuts for you. The recipe available at Taste of PNG at emtv.com.pg. In the meantime, we are on Facebook, we've got our own page. We are on Instagram. Send us a message. Love you all. Love Papua New Guinea. A bientôt. Au revoir. Bon appétit.
Taste of PNG is brought to you by Origin Energy.